Leviticus chapter 25. And the Lord spake unto Moses in Mount Sinai, saying, Speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, When ye come into the land which I give you, then shall the land keep a Sabbath unto the Lord. 6 years thou shalt sow thy field, and 6 years thou shalt prune thy vineyard, then gather in the fruit thereof. But in the 7th year shall be a Sabbath of rest unto the land, the Sabbath for the Lord. Thou shalt neither sow thy field nor prune thy vineyard. That which groweth of its own accord of thy heifer shalt thou not reap, neither gather the grapes of thy vine undressed. For it is a year of rest unto the land, and the Sabbath of the land shall be meet for you, for thee and for thy servants, and for thy maid, and for thy hired servant, and for thy stranger that sojourneth with thee, and for thy cattle, and for the beasts that are in thy land, shall the increase thereof be meet. And thou shalt number 7 Sabbaths of years unto thee, 7 times 7 years, and the space of the 7 Sabbaths of the year shall be unto thee 49 years. Then shalt thou cause the trumpet of jubilee to sound on the 10th day of the 7th month. In the day of atonement shall ye make the trumpet sound throughout all your land. And ye shall hallow the 50th year, and proclaim liberty throughout all the land unto all the inhabitants thereof. It shall be a jubilee unto you, and ye shall return every man unto his possession, and ye shall return every man unto his family. A jubilee shall that 50th year be unto you. Ye shall not sow, neither reap that which groweth of itself in it, nor gather the grapes in it of thy vine undressed. For it is the jubilee, it shall be holy unto you. Ye shall eat the increase thereof out of the field. In the year of jubilee ye shall return every man unto his possession. And if thou sell aught unto thy neighbor, or buyest aught of thy neighbor's hand, ye shall not oppress one another. According to the number of years after the jubilee, thou shalt buy of thy neighbor, and according unto the numbers of years of the fruits, he shall sell unto thee. According to the multitude of years, thou shalt increase the price thereof, and according to the fewness of years, thou shalt diminish the price of it. For according to the number of the years of the fruits, doth he sell unto thee. Ye shall not therefore oppress one another, but thou shalt fear thy God, for I am the Lord your God. Wherefore ye shall do my statutes, and keep my commandments, and do them. And ye shall dwell in the land and safety, and the land shall yield her fruit. And ye shall eat your fill, and dwell therein in safety. And if ye shall say, What shall we eat in the 7th year? Behold, we shall not sow, nor gather in or increase. Then I will commit my blessings upon your land in the 6th year, and it shall bring forth fruit for 3 years. And ye shall sow in the 8th year, and eat yet of the old fruit until the 9th year, until her fruits come in. Ye shall eat of the old store, and the land shall not be sold forever, for the land is mine, for ye are strangers that sojourneth with me. And in all the land of your possessions ye shall grant a redemption for the land. If thy brother be waxen poor, and had sold away some of his possession, and if any of his kin come to redeem it, then he shall redeem that which his brother sold. And if the man have none to redeem it, and himself be able to redeem it, then let him count the years of the sale thereof, and restore the overplus unto the man to whom he sold it, that he may return unto his possession. But if he be not able to restore it to him, then that which is sold shall remain in the hand of him that hath bought it until the year of jubilee. And in the jubilee it shall go out, and he shall return unto his possession. And if a man sell a dwelling house in a walled city, then he may redeem it within a whole year after it is sold. Within a full year may he redeem it. And if it be not redeemed within the space of a full year, then the house that is in the walled city shall be established forever to him that bought it throughout his generations. It shall not go out in the jubilee. But the houses of the villages which have no wall round about them shall be counted as the fields of the country. They may be redeemed, and they shall go out in the jubilee. Notwithstanding the cities of the Levites and the houses of the cities of their possession, may the Levites redeem at any time. And if a man purchase of the Levites, then the house that was sold and the city of his possession shall go out in the year of jubilee. For the houses of the cities of the Levites are their possession among the children of Israel. But the field of the suburbs of the city may not be sold, for it is their perpetual possession. And if thy brother be waxen poor, and fallen in the cave with thee, then thou shalt relieve him, yea, though he be a stranger or a sojourner, that he may live with thee. Take thou no usury of him or increase, but fear thy God, that thy brother may live with thee. Thou shalt not give him thy money upon usury, nor lend him thy victuals for increase. I am the Lord your God, which brought you forth out of the land of Egypt, to give you the land of Canaan, and to be your God. And if thy brother that dwelleth with thee be waxen poor, and be sold unto thee, then thou shalt not compel him to serve as a bond servant, but as a hired servant and a sojourner, he shall be with thee, and shall serve thee unto the year of Jubilee. And then shall he depart from thee, both he and his children with him, and shall return unto his own family, and unto the possession of his father shall he return. For they are my servants, which I brought forth out of the land of Egypt. They shall not be sold as bondmen. Thou shalt not rule over him with rigor, but shalt fear thy God. Both thy bondmen and thy bondmaids, which thou shalt have, shall be of the heathen that are round about you. Of them shall ye buy bondmen and bondmaids. Moreover, the children of the strangers that do sojourn among you, of them shall ye buy, and of their families that are with you, which they beget in the land, and they shall be your possession. And ye shall take them in the inheritance of your children after you, to inherit them for a possession. They shall be your bondmen forever, but over your brethren, the children of Israel, ye shall not rule one over another with rigor. And if a sojourner, a stranger, wax rich by thee, and thy brother that dwelleth by him wax poor, and sell him unto the stranger or sojourner by thee, or to the stock of the stranger's family, after that he is sold, he may be redeemed again. One of his brethren may redeem him, either his uncle or his uncle's son may redeem him, or any that is nigh of his kin unto him of his family may redeem him. If he be able, he may redeem himself, and he shall reckon with him that bought him from the year that he was sold to him unto the year of Jubilee, and the price of his sale shall be according unto the number of years, according to the time of an hired servant shall it be with him. If there be yet many years behind, according unto them, he shall give again the price of his redemption out of the money that he was bought for. And if there remain but few years unto the year of Jubilee, then he shall count with him, and according unto his years shall he give him again the price of his redemption. And as a yearly hired servant shall he be with him, and the other shall not rule with rigor over him in thy sight. And if he be not redeemed in these years, then he shall go out in the year of Jubilee, both he and his children with him. For unto me the children of Israel are servants. They are my servants, whom I brought forth out of the land of Egypt. I am the Lord your God.